So good morning. I'm Håkan Kodén from and the CEO from Eurostep Group. I will basically just give a few slides in the beginning here, and then I will hand over happily to Erik, who will do the real presentation. And then we'll, in the end, also make a short summary. We have been here before at PI Congress, where actually we have been here already 2013. And then we did the presentation of our software. But then in 2014, we talked about how we are supporting Siemens Energy with collaboration, linking Siemens PLM, SAP, other system into the supplier base. We talked 2 years ago about Volvo Trucks, how they did work in China in a joint venture with our software. Last year, in 2016, we were here again. But then we talked, we had a presentation together with Volvo Cars, who talked about what they are doing with the sort of new owner, Geely, and other companies around the Geely sphere, again around PLM collaboration. And this year, we are happy to be able to bring on stage Renault Group, or sometimes I say Renault Cars, but I guess Renault Group is the correct name here. Erik Delaporte, who we have been working with for, I don't know, less than a year, half a year or something, for another implementation of PLM collaboration. And I won't say any more, but I will happily hand over to you and Erik, and thank you for coming here and supporting us.
Thank you, Håkan. Hello, everybody. So I'm Erik Delaporte, working in IS/IT of Renault Engineering. So my customers are engineers designing cars, so that will be one of the next to be seen on the streets. And I'm responsible of OEM collaborations or project. So we will just a few words about Renault Groups, then an overview of PLM landscapes with two focus: engineering and process manufacturing. And then work on OEM collaborations on how we implement the standards. So Renault Group, this is a 2015 numbers, more than 120,000 employees, more than 2.8 million vehicles. I think 2016 was 3.1 million vehicles sold for the same brand. Renault, main brands, Dacia, and Renault-Samsung Motors. We have a unique alliance with Nissan, well-known automotive groups, and we have very strong partners like AvtoVAZ and Daimler. We have many engineering design centers at the heart of the group markets, so in Europe, in India, South Africa, Russia, Japan, South Korea, sorry. Japan is Nissan. And then we have also the main productions in the same thing, so plant everywhere, and the production is quite well split all over the world. That's a brief introduction of the total Renault Group. Now, our PLM landscapes. So at the top, you have the BOM system, which is in-house development, called Signe. Engineering is now mainly what we call new PLMs, because it's still new for us, based on Hennovia V6 from Dassault, with Scania V6. We have closed the legacy VPM before that was for powertrains, and we should close this year the legacy PLM, which was based on TC, Team Center Engineering, for vehicles with Scania V5. Requirement management is done using doors. We are still under study for model-based system engineering. It's a big subject, but not yet still in study. Manufacturing process is in the change, and we're implementing two different things: three-man chassis using Dacia V6, so integrated, and body-in-white using Team Center Manufacturing with Process Simulate. And after sales is what we call Phoenix, based on PTC. So many different vendors on the scope here. Now I will just have a focus on new PLMs. What is the main breakthrough? So first is, I will have a more detail of this smart configurable mock-up. This is really the change for us. Digital continuity for the process on the simulations. A strong focus of exchange, because we have our partner Nissan, which is using others' engineering tools, Teamcenter manufacturing and Teamcenter engineering, sorry, on NX, and collaborations with all the design centers over the world. We have seen that you have design center in Europe, but also in Russia and South America. Everybody needs to collaborate, you know, almost real times. It covers also all the documentation for the project. All the deliverables to engineer vehicles are stored here. And it forces or allows to have common process and methods, because before we have three tools different for powertrain, for vehicles, for electric vehicles. Now it's a single tools and process. The deployment is almost finished, so we have 12,000 new PDM users, and of which 4,300 are digital mockup users using InnoVIV 6. And end of migration should be mid of 2017. Some of you maybe have seen these slides 6 months ago, 3 months ago. It was Q1, so maybe you know the migration is very complex thing, so it's a slight delay. So what is the smart configurable digital mockup about? So I should have something pointed, yes. So we are able to visualize and to configure inside the PLM vehicles with any of these functions. First is define the different BOM variants. For example, some parts are valid for hatchback, for estates, I think it's the two vehicles here, and some for both. So based on this, you can filter and get a complete definition of the vehicles for any BOM variant available. This is very new for us. In the vehicle industry, we can have thousands or tens of thousands of variants for given vehicles, and for electric vehicles, I think it's up to 100,000 different variants. Of course, we don't analyze each, but we are able to analyze each which needs to. Of course, the digital mockups can be filtered using date effectivities, so what was valid at a given date. Also milestones, we have several milestones which schedules the developments, so main milestones are input and saved and can be retrieved any times. Of course, it is standard CAD volume selections, so what is inside the sites. And any attribute value of any part can be used to filter, extract some things, extract context. So this is a very big change for us, because our digital mockup is now complete and can be defined completely by variant attributes to select whatever you need in the vehicle. This is a real strange, a real strong change for us. In parallel, we have launched a 3D experience pilot named LCI, Laboratoire Commun d'Innovation, so Common Laboratory for Innovations, just orders. The objective is to have more transparency on projects, so collaborative platforms, all disciplines, to speed up the definition of concepts, validate faster, short iterations, more robustness of concepts using one digital mockup for design and engineering, and easier replicability of project and process using cloud solution, flexible, and so on. So this platform is based on the Dassault 3D Experience 2015X. It covers the 3D modeling, of course, different kind of modeling, simulation, ergonomic system behaviors, social and collaborative, and information intelligence, which covers KPI, dashboarding, data extraction and analysis for everything that has been put in the project and through the experience. So that is a pilot phase with only with 30 to 50 designers, and this is to decide where we want to go after 2 days new PDM. Next big change ongoing is a manufacturing process toward a full digital process. So we want to go from what we have right now, point-to-point manual collaborations and station robotic simulations, physical validation for feasibility, and to be the 100% integrated collaboration for extended enterprise. full inline robotic simulation, optimizations, and digital variation. I have some slides for this. So for the three-man chassis, we have a single systems based on V6 for the product definitions, and then for machining, which represents the same as the physical worlds and the digital worlds. So this is ongoing. I think the production for this will be in 2 weeks from now. So big change ongoing. And then we have the digital validation for the mounting check. So going from new PDM, you have the vehicles, you extract what is needed, and you are doing some mounting to check some virtual reality check to see if you are able to fit a part inside it before construction, only on digital. And if it goes white, it means that it has been effectively really dropped in the this means we know that it's possible to mount these parts in a given times. It's one of the key points to have a vehicle with a given price. So this is a big change of the manufacturing process. And now comes the OEM collaborations. As you have seen in introductions, Renault is a strong partnership with Nissan, with Daimler and others. So we have to go from our wonderful, completely digital, configurable digital mockups. So it's very complex. It's worked very well in V6. But you have to go to the other systems, simulations, realistic rendering, manufacturing process for body in white, team centers, repair and after sales PTC, increase efficiency of collaboration with Nissan and Daimler. They both use NX, team center engineering, and team center, I think, enterprise for Daimler, or something inside systems. And the stakes, as explained by business, is to allow fast loop between process definitions all downstreams. This means less than 24 hours for a complete vehicle transfer from Renault new PDMs in V6 in France to Japan, to Nissan NX PDM and team centers in Japan or Daimler. Yeah. And of course, we are in an industry where there is new partnerships and new collaborations every few months, and we need to reduce the delay and cost to start collaboration with OEM. Right now, it takes several, almost 1 year to set up a new fully exchange, data exchange, and it might be much shorter. So to do this, we have worked inside the Global Automotive Advisory Group, which uniting many different automotive company solutions for OEM collaborations. The use case we have, and probably there is many with the same, is cross manufacturing. Renault vehicle is produced in the Nissan plant. Component reuse, one powertrain from Renault is used in Daimler vehicles, in Renault vehicles or whatever else. Co-designs, same vehicles, same powertrain is developed at the same time by two companies. We have this for engine with Daimler and with Nissan for platform design for different vehicles. On co-design with partners, sometimes we subcontract a full body of a vehicle, like the hatchback will be done by the partner once we have the first vehicle produced. This is a use case we have to support. To do this, we have, with help from GAG, we have identification of potential vendors, benchmark, try to define how it works, so many people were involved. We have also looked at Boost Aero, which is done in the aerospace industry in France and Europe. So the solution was third-party vendor solutions, because we cannot rely on one vendor, otherwise one OEM is privileged or something like this. And we need to have standard connectors based on ISO standards, STEP AP240 on JT. That's the result of this group. So we need to exchange with standard formats. The reason for this is that by using standard for CAD and metadata, CAD and PDM version ups on one side are transparent for the others. At the beginning of Renault Nissan, we use native formats, and we have many pain to maintain this over the years. More components are reusable between different converters, different OEM. Based on this, Renault, Nissan, and Daimler decide to use STEP AP242 XML on JIT XTB Rep 9.5 for the experts to do this, and we are doing this since more than 1 year with Daimler. So this is working fine, but we still have specific data mapping, for each partnership. What it means is that when you write in steps, Daimler data write in steps is the Daimler structures. Renault structures write in step is the Renault structures. And you cannot import directly Renault structures in Daimler. You can import it as a CAD on simple structures, but it makes no sense for the business. It's a real Renault metadata, Renault systems, Renault things. You have to provide meaning to the business. So this is what is lacking right now. So we have worked with Nissan and Daimler to try to imagine or write a command exchange data model. It still use STEP AP242 XML, structure metadata, JIT for geometry, so no change on this. It's another level, another layer above this. It define a command dictionary of objects, so we can understand which object is input and what is the business meaning of this object. Some golden rules for the object dynamics, how does that change. It's generated at export to ease receiver mapping, also, and so on. So it doesn't change our PDMs, Nissan PDMs, or Daimler PDMs. It's just for export and exchange. No change of this. We want to share it with other OEMs. It's not private. It's more people using it, more easy it will be to exchange for new partner. And the idea is there is some metadata and structure change from my internal systems to the exchange data models. Now it's the same, so whatever I receive from Daimler or Nissan, it's almost the same data model, it contains the needed information. So we have defined these models focused on digital mockup exchange right now. Of course, it's not complete, it needs to be increased and add more information, but right now we say we want to implement what we have. So it started with Nissan, and we are in discussion with Daimler how to implement this, how to change this. Now the mapping is facilitated and can be automatized, and especially interface can be reused for other partnerships with very few modifications. That's the main advantage for us. How we can implement this, how to do this? So we start from, this is Renault point of view, probably Nissan or Daimler should have other slide for this, or way to do it. What we have standardized is the file exchange. We don't work on what is inside our systems. If they produce the files, it's okay for us. So we have the product definition in NOVA V6. We have set up some CAD conversions to the standard JIT. And this is a Renault data model, Renault database. To do this, we have created an exchange workspace, which is based on shared space for Eurosteps. Using common exchange data models inside the exchange workspace, inside shared space, with standard step AP242, common exchange DM, CEDM is common exchange data models, and JIT ISO. This allows us to have an easy export, parallel export from Renault new PDMs, and to provide this to all internal systems. So the start of production for these systems is today for manufacturing process. We put it in production today. My team is doing it. I hope it's going well. And then we keep track. These tools allow to keep track of all exchange. For example, the different system receivers don't use the same CAD format because internally we still have to use CATIA V5 for some tools. We are in the We want them to change to JIT, but it's not finished internally. It also keeps track of what has been sent, doing delta, many things, delta exchange. It allows easy management of exchange. I can do delta, I do not send you the JIT already sent, but then, oh, there is an issue on your side, then I need to force export it. And then it checks incoming data against BOM and PDM systems, and, import in parallel in V6. So the last two points, it's an ongoing project. We hope to deliver this in August 2017 with Nissan and with Daimler whenever we are there ready. So that's the perimeters of Exchange Workspace, what we have decided. So from business point of view, from the externals, what is important is standardize, do all this. And from the team which is performing the exchange, we need some tools to do it, and this is what we have done here, supporting it. We want to reduce the number of people which are doing the jobs every day and so on for all this. That's it. Sorry. Another way to present it like this, we have our new PDMs, all the downstream applications, the external things, on BOM systems. So what is inside all the projects is pre-conversions, JIT and V5 for internal use in parallel. We export the metadata from new PDMs without any CAD. Then Exchange Workspace here will analyze which target. Oh, this is for manufacturing process. Right now, they require both JIT and V5. So the system will request both JIT and V5 for every CAD needed and push them right where it's needed. And then export this, push in step E242, CDMs, and push to the right systems. So this is what we put in production today. For the import, mainly with Nissan and after with Daimler, we manage import with step EP242. There is some service to check what is incoming versus current systems to provide what we call a what-if analysis. If I import a package from Daimler, based on what is existing in the systems, based on the BOM systems, what will happen? The business can analyze and decide what will be important, new parts, new BOM parts, something like this. And now we can import in parallel, split package, import the CAD in parallel, and import structures. So this is all the functions we have in this Exchange Workspace. So the green part is in production today, and the yellow one mid to end of 2017, and so on. That's the main focus. So we have created what we call a breakthrough in Renault by the new digital mockups, fully configurations. And now what we need to know is to say how I provide this information and transfer to the rest of the systems. Right now, the jump was very strong from a business point of view. It's not so easy, so that it takes a lot of time to use and to define the process for a fully configurable digital mockup. But then, and this is done inside in FAV6, and then the challenge here is to bring this to the rest of the world, which is not so easy, in a very fast and reliable way and so on. A lot of, not just bring, but bring very fast. I think that's it for all the explanation of this. Next slide, I think, is for Snostinby. Oh yes, conclusion. You're right. So as I say, we have to go from a smart, fully configurable digital mockup. That's great. Created a breakthrough for vehicle engineering. They are still creating new process and improving it, providing new value based on this. But though now we have to adapt all downstream applications to this new capabilities, keeping digital continuity. For one part, and because of alliance and strong partnerships, we have to do it also with the rest of the world. This will be achieved using standards in all our exchange. That's the main focus point, plus creating the tool internally. No, this is the conclusion. You're right. Maybe I'm a bit too fast. I think it's okay.
So I will stay here. I would just finish this with a few words about us in Eurostep, and then we have time for questions with Eric. So I think we are really proud to have this fantastic lineup of customers here. We talked about Siemens, we talked about Volvo Trucks and Volvo Cars, and now Renault, a great company. And you're a busy person, Eric, so thank you very much for coming here. You have a lot of things going on at home, it's clear. So we have these fantastic references with ShareSpace. a good reputation. We participate a lot in this standardization work and implementing these standards and so on. And we do it, I think, in a very good way. Good profit, nice growth, 15-20% per year, which is a healthy growth. And then we have this experience from projects. And that's when I listened before this presentation, I went in to listen to the Rheinmetall presentation. And it's really about a lot experience in these PLM projects in general, PDM in general, PLM in general, but then also PLM collaboration. And the gentleman from RMV, he was talking a lot about how they are doing their business with acquiring companies, doing joint ventures, and in the end, he really said we had to leave a bit early, but there was no way to enforce the same PLM solution into all the supplier base or partners or joint ventures and so on. And this case here with Renault is a good example as well, where the automotive industry previously have been able to force the same solution to the supplier base, but when there's this OEM to OEM, there's a battle between the equals, and then you have to meet some other place than just throwing tools on your supplier thing. So this is, we know a lot about this, and we're proud to do that. We want this to be easier and easier. Eric and our project, Eric's team, our team is still fighting to get this in operations on it. It's not easy enough, but we are, of course, putting a lot of effort making it even easier. And then, just for you to think about, I know when we had Volvo Trucks here 2 years ago, one person there in that team, he has actually the title of collaboration manager, I think. I think, Eric, you have some collaboration tools or something in your title. And I just want to encourage industrial companies in the room that I think collaboration itself, extended enterprise collaboration with other OEMs, with joint ventures, it's very, very important. It doesn't really happen by itself, by putting a CAD guy there, or a PDM guy, or a quality guy there. It's a discipline in itself to really be very skilled about. So think about that. If you don't have it, I think you should have it, because everyone, where the shortcomings is really when data is entering and leaving the company. So collaboration is really important. We do this, and if there's anyone who wants to talk to us after this presentation during the next 2 days, we are in the exhibition. It's me, it's Christian Giraud, who is heading up Eurostep in France. It's Per Linde, who's sales executive, and also we have Staffan Söderberg, who is working for Eurostep in Germany. So talk to any one of us. Eric, you're around for 2 days as well, I think. So with that, thank you very much. And we have time for, we have at least 5 minutes, I would say. Questions?
Hello, I really enjoyed your presentation, and being a car company, I expect that a lot of CAD, focus on CAD and that integration and data management. The question is, how do you manage the life cycle between all those items?
Right now, we are in a process to align the project development process, not strictly, but at major milestones between us and OEMs. So we don't want to be fully exactly mapped, but there is some rendezvous points which need to be met, and this is ongoing. Right now, it's a very interesting question inside the Renault Group, because as you've seen, we have our BOM systems and PDM system, which is different. On the BOM exchange right now are managed also differently right now. So it's very difficult to have a single coherent life cycle for both the BOM information and PDM and CAD information. The first steps to go to this is we are changing BOM systems to align with Nissan's. And in these new systems, we include the PDM information in this new BOM. We include the PDM information and try to work on this. It's not yet achieved right now. It's under study by business on this.
Can I add to it? Yeah. The software share space is based on the STEP standard and also part of the STEP standard called PLCS, Product Lifecycle Support. So even if Eric is, I don't think never you talk about PLCS as such, it's really built into the solution. So there should be capabilities to add life cycle kind of information on top of the solution that is currently in place.
Yes. And in fact, when we discussed the common echelon data model with NISA and Daimler's, we clearly identified that one of the next things to do is to say, I need a coherent export from all my systems for a given business task, because the receivers and the producers don't have the same way to dispatch the information in the systems. So maybe I should take information in two systems, provide this to Daimler's, and they restore in three systems, and whatever. So we want to have a current export for given milestone, lifecycle states, project informations. But right now we focus to exchange digital mockups, and we know there is a next next steps, which is works on coherent exports, many systems to many systems.
Good morning, Frédéric Berthaud, Airbus. So you explained that your bomb management is still a part of your new PDM. Do you intend to incorporate this capability into the new PDM, or do you want to let it apart? And the second question will be with the ERP integration. So we saw Delmia V6, but what about your integration with the ERP world? Thank you.
So for the first questions, there has been some analysis in Renault, but in fact, the priority has been to use a single, to go to one BOM system between Renault and Nissan, including ERP, so this is for the second. So because we don't have the same PDMs, we cannot directly include the BOM system inside new PDMs because we need to have one with Nissan. What we have is this, the BOM structures and BOM parts, they are reflected in the PDMs with all the variant information, so we can configure digital mockup. But it's not, it's two systems. And the same for ERP, it's I would say a complex set of tools, but again, they will not go into Innovia because we are focusing on sharing with Nissan this part, especially what is needed is any car in any plant from Renault, from Allianz point of view. And for this, it's more important to have one BOM on a single ERP system, or kind of merge, not single, but kind of merge.
Thank you very much, Eric.
Thank you.
Thank you, Eric.